When you take a look at a community, many behaviors and various statistics can give us clues to how healthy the average individual in that community is. The data we use to assess the health of a community are called health indicators. Health indicators can include very health-specific information, such as rates of disease, or the percent of the population who have health insurance, or who are up to date on their immunizations. Other health indicators might be less obvious, like the education level in the community, or poverty rates. These last two items might seem completely unrelated to community health, but they actually can be very telling when we examine health statistics. In order to promote healthy communities in the United States, the federal government wrote a plan called Healthy People. The current plan, known as Healthy People 2020, identifies 12 major public health concerns in the U.S. called leading health indicators. These leading health indicators outline the most important information we can look at to determine the relative healthiness of different communities within the United States. They provide a means for us to measure good health so we can improve the overall health of our people. Let's take a close look at each one of the leading health indicators so we can be familiar with them. The first leading health indicator is social determinants, like education, jobs, wealth, and safe housing and neighborhoods. You may wonder what these things have to do with your health. Actually, education is one of the strongest indicators of good health. Statistics show that individuals who get a good education are more knowledgeable about what it takes to maintain good health. They are more likely to be able to get high-paying jobs that allow them to buy homes in safe, low-crime neighborhoods and purchase nutritious foods and good health insurance. So while social determinants may seem unrelated to health at first glance, they can actually play a major role in the health of a community. The next leading health indicator is tobacco use. Just about everyone knows that smoking or chewing tobacco is not good for you. It can cause heart and lung disease and a number of different types of cancer. Tobacco use is actually the single most preventable cause of disease, disability, and death in the United States. Tobacco use causes more deaths each year than all the deaths from HIV, drugs, alcohol, car crashes, suicides, and murders combined. You can see why tobacco use is one of the biggest health concerns facing our country. Reproductive and sexual health is another leading health indicator. This health concern focuses on preventing and treating sexually transmitted diseases, preventing unwanted pregnancies, and making sure that women who are pregnant stay healthy and deliver healthy babies. Improving reproductive and sexual health can reduce rates of infectious diseases like STDs and can increase education and career opportunities and financial stability by reducing the number of unplanned pregnancies. Quite obviously, reproductive health is an important concern. Healthy People 2020 also identifies injury and violence to be another leading health indicator. Injury and violence includes things that cause physical harm or death, for example, car crashes, domestic abuse, suicides, or murder. Both unintentional injuries and those caused by acts of violence are among the top 15 killers of Americans, and the consequences can be more than physical. In addition to their immediate health impact, injuries and violence can affect the social and emotional health of victims as well as their friends and family. Oral health refers to the condition of a person's teeth and gums and is another leading health indicator. Scientific evidence shows that oral health is highly correlated to an individual's overall health, and gum disease in particular is associated with diabetes, heart disease, and stroke. Regular visits to the dentist can help to protect your oral health, but unfortunately, many Americans do not receive this type of care. Clinical preventative services is a health indicator that includes scheduled immunizations and routine screenings for diseases like cancer, diabetes, or sexually transmitted diseases. Clinical preventative services can detect illnesses in their earlier, more treatable stages, or even prevent them altogether. Prevention is critical to reducing death, disability, and disease, and can even save money down the road by avoiding the need for costly treatments associated with advanced illnesses. Nevertheless, increasing the use of preventative health services continues to be a major public health challenge. Another leading health indicator, and probably the most obvious one, is nutrition, physical activity, and obesity. Consuming a healthful diet and getting enough exercise is arguably the most important thing one can do for overall good health and well-being. Unfortunately, most Americans do not eat a healthy diet or get enough physical activity, which has led to the obesity epidemic we see in our population today. Obesity is related to conditions like high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, heart disease, stroke, and osteoarthritis. Ensuring that all Americans participate in regular physical activity and consume a healthy diet would help decrease the incidence of obesity and help the population avoid these illnesses. For this reason, nutrition, physical activity, and obesity is a critical public health concern. Substance abuse is a leading health indicator that focuses on preventing and treating alcohol and drug abuse. In 2005, roughly 22 million Americans struggled with a drug or alcohol problem. Excessive consumption of alcohol and the use of illegal drugs are associated with a number of negative health impacts, including cardiovascular conditions, STDs, complications with pregnancy, domestic violence, car accidents, homicide, and suicide. Progress has been made in lowering the rates of substance abuse in the U.S., but unfortunately, substance abuse continues to be a leading health problem nationwide. The next leading health indicator is mental health, which focuses on preventing, diagnosing, and treating mental health disorders like depression or anxiety. Mental health is inextricably linked with physical health. Data shows that mental health disorders are associated with the occurrence of serious chronic conditions like diabetes, heart disease, and cancer. Therefore, if we can improve the mental health of Americans nationwide, then we can also improve overall physical health and well-being. Environmental quality is a leading health indicator that is concerned with having safe air, land, and water for a healthy community. Poor air quality and contaminated soil and water can lead to asthma, gastrointestinal illnesses, neurological problems, various types of cancer, and even death. It's important to keep our environments safe and free of pollutants because the environment plays a critical role in the quality of life and the number of healthy years an individual can live within the community. Access to health services is another leading health indicator that deals with increasing the number of Americans who have health insurance and improving the quality of care they can receive with regular medical checkups. Routine medical care and reliable access to health services can help to prevent diseases and also detect illnesses early so they can be treated quickly. Increasing access to medical care and insurance is therefore a vital step to improving the health of all Americans. The last leading health indicator included in Healthy People 2020 is maternal, infant, and child health. This health indicator examines the well-being of pregnant women in order to reduce the number of premature births and infant deaths. If the U.S. can focus on providing good medical care for mothers, then we can prevent death and disability amongst babies so that, as children, they can reach their full potential. These 12 leading health indicators represent the major public health concerns in the United States. It's important to note that some of these health indicators may overlap. For example, social determinants, like financial stability, might influence an individual's access to health services. Substance abuse could affect reproductive and sexual health, or injury and violence, if someone is making poor choices while under the influence of drugs or alcohol. Certainly, many of these health indicators are related on some level, and lots of overlap can occur. The 12 health indicators are used to measure the relative health of a community so health officials can gauge improvements over time. Healthy People 2020 created this list of 12 indicators with four goals in mind. First, to increase the quality and years of healthy life for people living in the United States. Second, to create social and physical environments that promote good health. Third, to promote healthy behaviors and proper development across all life stages. And finally, to improve the health of all populations while eliminating health disparities or differences in health across different groups of people. This last goal is particularly important because we want people of all ages, races, ethnicities, and financial situations to be healthy, not just the young and socially elite. These are lofty but worthwhile goals set by Healthy People 2020. The 12 leading health indicators we discussed can be used to measure the extent to which these goals are being achieved over time. Keeping the 12 leading health indicators in mind, how healthy is your community, in your opinion? Is there room for improvement? Remember that if you can act on even one of the health indicators in your own life, you can increase the quality and years of healthy life for yourself. Your healthy choices can serve as a good example for other people in your family and community to follow. By making healthy choices for yourself and encouraging others to do the same, you can help to advocate for better health in your community and also help to close the gaps or disparities in health across the country. Which health indicator will you choose to work on first?